Hey guys, in this brand new video, we're going to continue with our conversation on calculating equilibrium concentrations. So let's take a look at this particular question. We're going to say when 0.600 atmospheres of NO2 was allowed to come to equilibrium, the total pressure was 0.875 atmospheres. Calculate the Kp of the reaction. Now, all I'm giving you is 0.600 atmospheres of NO2. I'm saying I'm allowing it to come to equilibrium. What that tells me is this amount is not my equilibrium amount. It's rather my initial amount. So this is my initial pressure. So all we say to ourselves is, do we have to use an ice chart? And the answer here is yes, because we're gonna have this missing an equilibrium amount, this is missing an equilibrium amount, and this is missing an equilibrium amount. Anytime more than one of my compounds in my balanced equation is missing an equilibrium amount, I have to do an ice chart. This number here, I'm giving it time to get to equilibrium, which means it's my initial pressure. So we're gonna say I is initial, C is change, E is equilibrium. So we're gonna say initially we're starting out with 0.600 atmospheres. And remember, atmospheres goes with Kp. I don't tell us anything about NO or O2, so they're initially at zero. Remember the important phrase we've been saying. We're losing reactants to make products. So this is going to be minus 2x because of the 2. And it's minus because it's a reactant. Plus 2x. The 2 there, that's why it's plus 2x. Plus x. Bring down everything. 0.600 minus 2x plus 2x plus x. Now, what we should realize here is they're telling me what the total pressure is. Now, this goes back to Henry's law. Or actually, not Henry's law, but more importantly, Dalton's law. Dalton's law says that the total pressure that we experience is equal to the pressure of all of the gases added up. So my total pressure is equal to the pressure of NO2 plus the pressure of NO plus the pressure of O2. And at equilibrium, that's my equilibrium total pressure. So what we're going to do here is say at equilibrium, each of these gases is equal to each of these equations. So at equilibrium, our total pressure is 0.875 atmospheres. At equilibrium, NO2 is 0.600 minus 2x. At equilibrium, NO is 2x. At equilibrium, O2 is just x. We're gonna say that this negative 2 and this positive 2 basically cancel each other out. So our equation becomes 0.875 atmospheres equals 0.600 plus x. We need to isolate x here, so we're going to subtract 0.600, 0.600. So x here equals 0.275 atmospheres. Remember, this is Dalton's law. The total pressure we experience is the pressure from all of the gases added up together. And since this is an equilibrium total pressure, we use the equilibrium equations for each of the compounds. We just isolated what x is, so all we need to do is take this x answer, plug it in here, plug it in here, plug it in here. And we'll know each of them at equilibrium. And if we know each of them at equilibrium, then it's those equilibrium amounts that we plug into Kp. Remember, Kp is just products over reactants, so it's NO squared times O2 divided by NO2 squared because of the 2 and the 2 here. So when we plug in the x in for NO2, we get 0.050 atmospheres. When we plug it in for NO, at equilibrium NO equals 2x, plug in the x answer we just found. So that's NO. And then O2 is just equal to x at equilibrium, so it's that same exact number. Now take all those numbers and plug it in. And when you do all that, you'll get your KP equal to 33.28. Now to do this question, you had to have a knowledge of Dalton's law, and remember that deals with gases, and then apply that concept to this new idea of an ice chart. So it's kind of taking a little bit of old information, combining it with some new information in order to obtain our KP value.